1, baby. Here we are. It's live. It's here. It's fucking football. And we're going to see it firsthand. Welcome, everybody. It's Bell in the Birdman, Friday edition. More content, more shows, and a lot more airplanes in our future. I'm John Barchard, Vince Quinn, Taylor Credatis, all here. I don't know why you are dressed in red, but I'm just going to say welcome to Hurt Season once again, Vince Quinn, and I hope your bags are packed.
All right. Well, my bags are packed, but here's why I'm wearing the sweatshirt, John.
Lady in red. No, not that. Okay.
No, great song. Hot water went out in my apartment.
That is true.
I haven't had hot water in like 4 days.
That's what smells in here.
It is. I've been trying. I thought it was me. I put this on in part to contain the stink. This is my legitimate effort to contain the stink because showering has been hard to come by.
No cold showers?
No, the water pressure doesn't even go.
Oh,
like
you didn't mention that part.
It's so weak in the water pressure that I tried to turn the shower on and it doesn't even do it.
So what you're saying is Dan Campbell came in there, bit some pipe kneecaps, and you know, brought the water pressure down, and we owe him one, is what you're saying.
Yeah, he was like, "Listen, man, I don't care if you got three toes and one butt cheek. I'm gonna cut you down.
I'm gonna mess you up." And honestly, we're just gonna nerd out today. This is all about, you know, let's break down Detroit. We get to break down an actual physical game that's going to matter on the schedule
and
have fun in front of all these sold out fuck faces that think they have some hope here.
I'm sure they're nice.
I know. I'm just trying to get it.
Yeah, they're fuck faces.
Yeah, fuck them.
We're coming to your city. Yeah. Fuck you, Detroit.
But also, we really hope we have a great time in front of everybody.
And give us pizza recommendations. Yeah,
please. Thank you.
I don't want to be a tourist.
But I think I'm just jacked up by that. It's going to be such a hostile environment. We're going to be sitting right in the middle of it. Hopefully, the Wi-Fi is good enough where we're going to be live streaming it so you can kind of get the viewpoint, and that's really cool. We're excited about that and cross your fingers, hope that works out. But, like, even if it doesn't, I am so ready to see this football game. Like, the greatest sound in the world at, like, 4:21 p.m. You want to know what it is? Ready? That. Dead silence after the sold-out crowd just is like, you know, like that's all you hear in the background. And then just us, these rabid, dumbass, wonderful Eagles fans, you know, celebrating like another 44-6 victory or something. I'm feeling the juice of everything else and can't wait to get into it and break it down. But Vince Quinn, who has read this more than I have, and I just saw the headline and thought it was interesting. There are some interesting things that did happen this offseason, you know, like, we've been talking about it a lot in terms of, was A.J. Brown a plan, or was it a thing, or was it this, or was it that? And, like, you know, The Athletic, I think, on Thursday kind of came out and said, like, well, you know, the Eagles and that whole deal with Allen Robinson was pretty close to a marriage, right, essentially.
Yeah, no, that was going to happen. It said they were deep in negotiations, which figures they're just talking about little nuances to try to iron things out. So they wanted Allen Robinson. They went after him. They were going to get Allen Robinson. The Rams were like, hey, Al, just hang up a minute. Just give Sean McVay some time.
Yeah.
We're going to get Sean McVay. We're going to get Matt Stafford. They just went on some island vacation, and they had a great time together.
But I thought Aaron Donald was retiring. No. We've taken care of that.
Yeah. to the tune of over $30 million a year. He's making over $30 million. He's making almost $32 million a year, which
probably
is
still
insane.
Underpaid.
He might be. Right. He might be.
Especially after, you know, two helmet swings. He probably should have been more like $100 million.
Yeah, come on. Get that guy an endorsement hitting people with helmets. But they did all that. So they're like, listen, Allen Robinson, you got to hang on here. Talk to these guys. And then he sure shit ends up signing with the Rams.
Yeah.
So that was their guy. Like, they did not plan for A.J. Brown. They were not expecting this, and it just kind of fell into their lap, which is what we felt at the time.
I still don't know.
We were at the point where we were talking about DeVante Parker, and that was
very true.
It was bad. We mentioned A.J. Green on this show at, like, 36. That was
exactly, that was
our best option available. Yeah, as Taylor yells yuck from across the room. Like, it was bad.
You know, like, this had to be, unless what? The only other thing that I can come up with then is like they were dead set on Allen Robinson. They were dead set on, you know, who's the first one that they missed on? That's now suspended for a year. It's escaping
my
mind.
Oh, Calvin Ridley.
Yeah, Calvin Ridley. Yeah. And that could have gone that way. So what? Did Jalen Hurts just say, Howie, come on, man. Like, don't give me Allen Robinson. Go get me my best friend. Just go pay what you got
to
pay.
Well, Allen Robinson leads to the existence of A.J. Brown as a trade entity. You know what I mean? Because think about what happened in this offseason. You get Christian Kirk.
Yeah,
he gets
all
paid.
Post Allen Robinson,
yes.
Right?
You're he
right.
Gets, yeah. He gets paid. So, like, Kirk resets the market because everyone was like, all right, he's good. But he was like, he's making like $19 million a year. What the fuck
Did
is that?
Did you almost go into a Howie voice there?
I think he wanted to. That
it's
awesome.
Like, it's
What's
weird.
He doing, man? I,
come
we
on,
can't
man.
Do that,
you,
man.
Come on, Doug, man. Bro.
Well, thank God Allen Robinson went to Los Angeles because I'm sure he looked at this situation and be like, doesn't look like the Bears, but it could smell like it if Jalen Hurts isn't. And they just won the Super Bowl and it's L.A., so yes, like, totally understand why Allen Robinson would do that.
Yeah, he's like, it smells like Vince hasn't showered in a couple days. So
water pressure in Philly sucks.
Yeah,
I'm out of here.
I'm out. But yeah, it's for Allen Robinson, it would be, yeah, is Jalen Hurts the guy that I want to tie my ship to right now? I don't know what the hell's going on over there. I can go to Sean McVay. I can go to Cooper Kupp and see what they've done. Robert Woods, what he's done. He's going to be like, I'm fucking better than Robert Woods.
Not
going to
forget that in the NFC Championship game, by the way. Allen.
Well, that's where it gets really interesting. Cause I'm not glad about it. Like,
no.
Allen Robinson,
fuck him.
He's really fucking good, man. Allen Robinson can play his ass off.
No, he's not that good.
No, he is that
he's
good.
He's good. He is good.
He is really good.
He's Penn State good.
He's, no, he's good.
Yeah. Everybody knows what I'm talking about.
Penn State good is KJ.
All right,
Hamlin,
Iowa.
Right?
Two safeties.
Get him.
Yeah, we stink. It's. I'm not even trying to compare. But
like,
anyway.
KJ Hamler is Penn State good.
Yeah.
You know, like,
yeah,
he
right,
became
fair.
Nothing once
You're
he
right.
got to the pros. Like, that's just what happens with all those receivers. But that guy can play his ass off. I mean, really, thinking about this season, like, Allen Robinson's going to go off. He's going to go so off this year. If you've got him on your fantasy team, like, that guy's blowing the fuck up. I'm just telling you. I fully believe in Allen Robinson and what he's going to do with that team.
We'll see about that. And that's kind of like what, you know, this whole, which is so weird because the Lions, and now I wonder. You know, now we have retrospect on Allen Robinson, but there is a little bit of history here with the Lions and the Eagles in terms of, like, I think duping, we can say at this point. And who knows, Jameson Williams might be like a superstar wide receiver. I wanted him here. You wanted him here.
Yep.
We would have been very happy with that. But I wonder if, like, clearly the Eagles knew that A.J. Brown was secured and ready to rock and roll by draft night. They played it up that was going to happen. They probably fed it to our good friend Peter Schrager, which is why I got mad at it, you know. But, like, Detroit jumped up. And then the next thing you know, what do you think they thought of when it was like, oh, yeah, by the way, the Eagles traded for A.J. Brown? They're like, oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Fuck. We could have just fuck. Fuck. Like, right? Like, they probably found out that they paid a little too much. And on top of that, which is a perfect segue to kind of get into the Lions stuff here, like, you know, between that, you've got 44-6, and Dan Campbell has referenced that a couple of times, and I think I only read the transcript, so I didn't see the video, but there was a couple of days ago when he's in his press conference, and he's going, oh, yeah, we remember real good what they were trying to do, and they'll probably come in and try and do it again, and kind of like, it seemed like the answer turned almost, like he caught himself, he didn't want to put bulletin board material on,
yeah.
But you know that these assholes, you know, maybe they don't do or don't care about the Jameson Williams thing, but they definitely care about the 44-6 thing. I think the Hard Knocks play up is beautiful because it kind of ties into the sold out crowd and like they're getting hype about this. There's no way they could be this bad. And, you know, it's still Jared Goff. It's still, you still have a really bad offensive line. Like, you know, and I even, you know, both of us kind of went back and watched that game, you more extensively than I, but. They did not do anything fancy. This was Boston Scott, Jordan Howard, a good offensive line, a couple of good, great dekes and runs from Jalen Hurts. And that was it. Like, they couldn't do anything. And I don't think they can really do much now. It's an improved team. I like some of the roster spots that they have there. But, like, pissed off or not, people are trying to buy into, yeah, the Lions are going to be a different team. The Eagles are in trouble. Are you trying to, like... I'm nowhere near that. nowhere near that. I think they're just, it's just great to look at, and Dan Campbell's fun to talk to, and I hope Deuce has a good career. And I'm honestly rooting for the Lions. I really do. If the Eagles somehow end up losing this game, ah, well.
There's no ah well to losing to the Lions. There's no ah well. There's not. There cannot be an oh well to lose
not
to
more
this
than the
team.
Eagles, by the way. Don't shut up and fucking don't put your Twitters down. Anyway, go ahead.
No, yeah. Like let's get this straight, okay? The Lions fucking blow.
They blow.
That team blows.
Not good.
They suck. And they have not done anything to really get significantly better from last season to this one. There's not a whole lot going on. And Jameson Williams, he ain't playing in this game.
Right.
He's not ready yet. He's still recovering from a torn ACL. The biggest thing that everybody's so hyped up about when it comes to the Detroit Lions is, oh my God, did you see their sixth-round linebacker on Hard Knocks? His last name is Rodriguez, but they call him Rodrigo. Can you believe that? What a great nickname. Rodrigo. Wow, they call this Rodriguez Rodrigo. They said it like 50 times on the goddamn show. It's not creative. So that's the thing that everyone's so excited about. Sure, if you want to be excited about a team that's so bad that a six-round rookie is a shoe-in starter, I see a lot of problems over
that's
there.
That's not great.
You know, it's not a great place to be. I bet the kid's okay. Is he oh my God, amazing? Is he the biggest mistake that the whole league is going to regret? I doubt it, okay?
Yeah.
It's the Lions. Like, their whole thing right now is grit and determination and playing hard, which is language for, oh, she's really nice. You know, I'm just saying, like, that's what people do. I remember getting set up for dances in high school. They'd be like, oh, well, she's really nice. And it's like, okay, well, you didn't want to say something else there. And that's what the Lions are. They're saying grit because they have no talent. They don't have talent on the team. So it's not nearly enough.
It's not, none of it's cohesive. None of it's like, I who is their identity? Oh, they're tough guys. Like, all right. So there's the dude who is the hometown fella that, for whatever reason, Doug Peterson didn't want it, you know, Hutchinson there, and you know, now that I think is the biggest, most gigantic improvement that they've made in the offseason. 100% understand that. Let's find out when he gets stood up by a guy that's only been playing the game for 3 years, and that's kind of like, you know. Whatever you want to say about where Jordan Mailata is at in his career is like, I don't think none of us would have said that before he got paid. None of us. But now it's like, I for every talented piece that they might have on that side, there's just so many other answers to be like, yeah, okay, but that's really the only piece. And if you got to just neutralize that, Jalen's legs will probably take care of, you know, some of that. AJ Brown's going to take care of a lot. It's just there's so many mismatches again. Amon St. Brown, great player, not scared at all. It fucking Slay in the opener as captain for the very first time in his career. You know, Brandon Graham, we don't know if he's going to be an Eagle. We know he wants to play here. This is his hometown too. Like, it is kind of a home game, despite the hype around the Lions for a lot of Eagles players here. And like, yeah, I just don't. I respect the Lions fan base so much, like I said, but like it's just for hopes and dreams here.
Yeah, like I feel for Lions fans too, and I get what they're doing, and I think for right now Dan Campbell is the right guy for what they're trying to do.
Yeah.
They just want people to walk into the locker room and not feel miserable. They just want to feel like an actual team of people that are doing something.
Yep.
Like it's all vibes right now. So fine, getting Hutchinson, like he looks good so far. We'll see where it goes. But is this it? Like the talent disparity between the Eagles and the Lions is so enormous, you know, that there's no way that the Eagles should lose this game. Like, there's no acceptable scenario. I think your room for error is monstrous.
Huge, yeah. And it was last year, too.
Throw a pick six to start the game. Who gives a fuck?
Yep.
It really should not be close when the gap in talent is this far. Because that's the biggest thing, going back and watching the game last year. What's the difference? The Lions just can't play. Like, the Eagles, every single run, it's 5-6 yards every single time. They weren't breaking it for 20, but they just couldn't stop the run, and they kept getting 5 or 6 yards every time. Like, they just couldn't do any big play they had. They couldn't string together anything after that. They might throw the ball 15, 20 yards down the field. Hawkinson catches it. It's a nice play. Yeah, good for him. But like, it's the one good thing they've got.
There you go.
But they, like, he makes a play like that, they can't do anything with it.
And the offense is actually steering away from him now, which is, I think, is a huge mistake.
It's a mistake. He's one of two high quality offensive pieces they have. If you want to believe that like DeAndre Swift is that guy, good luck. I think he's a good player. I don't think he's a great player. And I say that as a St. Joe's Prep guy. Yeah, Prep. So. like,
that's why you're wearing red too.
That's there. Okay. There we go.
That
yeah,
don't make sense.
It combines with the smell. But when it all boils down to it, it's just like it, I don't care that it's a road game. I don't care about all this hype around Hard Knocks, like all the things that you saw on Hard Knocks when it comes to energy and the vibes and the great stories. Like
one ass cheek.
Yeah, like all that shit happened here too. Mm-hmm. Oh, Aiden Hutchinson sang Billie Jean and everybody loved it. Well, you know what? Jordan Davis sang. What did he sing? Everybody fucking loved that too. Like
I can't even remember. But
who
it was
cares?
Great. Yeah.
It's just the idea of like all those things that we saw and felt with Hard Knocks. They're happening here too.
It
just wasn't televised. It's the only difference. It wasn't televised. It wasn't HBO special. So like everybody's like, oh my god, we should fear the Lions. No, you shouldn't. It's all delusional, buying into what's in front of you nonsense. When everything football wise should tell you this team is so much better. I even believe in more Sirianni and Gannon as a coaching staff than I believe in anything that's going on in Detroit. And I like their coaching staff for the same reason. It's like, you watch Hard Knocks. Who is it? It's Hank Fraley. He's a former player. It's Aaron Glenn, former player. Deuce Staley, former player. Mark Brunell, former player. Everything all up and down. All these guys played in the league,
football
including Dan
guys.
Campbell. That's what he's building. I totally get it. But is that a great staff? Are they going to out-coach the Eagles? Are they going to come up with this dynamic game plan? Like, I don't believe that.
Yeah.
I don't believe that for a second. And I think to really be afraid of the Lions, if anybody is like insane, and they're just there's no room to lose this game.
There's actually there's something in my mind that I think is comparable very much to the Lions coaching staff, and I want you to tell me if I'm right or not.
Oh God!
But I just want to crack this very special can of the best sparkling flavored mountain water in the land. It is the Liquid Death, a severed lime, like I've been telling you, this has been my drink of the summer. The OG Liquid Death cans that, of course, Vince has been drinking for the last 2 days is a staple in Sandbox Studios, in our fridges, makes Vince look tough when he crushes the can, et cetera, et cetera. But more importantly, it's recyclable. All the plastic shit that we use on a single-serve basis, whether it's an event or a party or going to a concert, it just is like plastic is no longer recyclable. There's no, if you think you're throwing it into that blue container and being like, I'm helping the environment, no, you're not. You're sending it to a landfill in fucking New Jersey. Like, and it's just like, it's terrible. Like, that's why, you know, Live Nation has partnered with Liquid Death, and you're starting to see all this aluminum show up all over the place. It's one of the things that we're one of the most things we're proud of, because we do a lot of events. We do a lot of things on the road, on buses, on planes, around people. And, you know, the less the carbon footprint, the better. But more importantly, this shit tastes amazing. The sparkling flavors, I've been blown away every time I go back. That's why I've been addicted to it basically since the spring. LiquidDeath.com/bell to get your case shipped to you for free with every order. And sign up for the subscription, because then it's just free shipping every time and you don't have to worry about it. Helps us very much, helps Liquid Death, and helps you murder your thirst, ladies and gentlemen. It's pretty easy. So cheers to a season. And of course we have to go with the severed line. It's a green can. It's a green can. Quick note, by the way.
Yeah.
I think you were right on this. I think Julian is getting wise as the stupid, unfortunately, this is where I got to come back and knock him just real quick and then bring him back to the thing.
All right, yeah.
We are unfortunately going to go with the stupid new letterhead, right? But it's not till 2024?
Well,
or 2023?
No, 2024.
Okay.
The new word mark.
Which you said that point, the jerseys will be
Kelly Green.
Oh, thank God. Thank God. You guys are going to, all you stupid assholes that have been yelling about Midnight Green is what we want. You're going to be, the moment those come on, you're going to be like, I was wrong. I'm sorry. The old boomers were right. But here's what I'm thinking. Back to, I think the Lions coaching staff is equivalent to the Gridiron Gang. And it's The Rock, like, and that group of like with Exhibit, and like it's just it feels like it's the same like carbon copy feel of like run through me, goddammit. How are you going to know if you're a man? Like, it's just like, it is very similar. If you've ever seen, that movie?
No.
I've never seen it. We were watching the program and we were watching Gridiron Gang, but watch the trailer of Gridiron Gang. And be like, oh, that's Dan Campbell.
Well, for what it's worth, more importantly, we have played Jerry Rice and Nidus's dog football. We did.
Yeah, bonus content on YouTube.
Yeah, right, that is a video game that actually exists, and we did play that, and it was fucking hilarious. But, that's what the coaching staff is, right? That first episode of Hard Knocks, what you see is Deuce Staley and Aaron Glenn just yelling at each other. Like, that's the whole episode. It's just they're going back and forth. It's all the shit stirring. It's just like, yeah, they're trying to not have a losing culture. That is the biggest thing that they're fighting. That's it. So I'm not worried about this team.
Don't be worried about it.
Yeah, I'm not worried about it at all. They should run away with this game again because the Lions are just outright bad and will make bad plays, and they don't have the talent. And even if you like the offensive line, it's injured right now. So Big V is not in this game. Frank Ragnow is their center. He's really fucking good. He's banged up right now. We don't know what the status is of that. Josh Sweat fucking owned them last game. Mm-hmm. I mean, absolutely owned them. He had 2 sacks. He was all over it. And thinking of Hassan Reddick being on the other side with that now, are you kidding me? Like,
well, and like we mentioned yesterday, like, that's where I think N'Kobe Dean's, it's a big opportunities for the linebackers here, even though it's kind of like everybody's not sure how they're going to operate. But yeah, like Swiss cheese nation it was.
Yeah.
And that's going to continue to happen, which you brought this up. Great question, because we'll get back into the defense in a little bit.
Yeah.
But how do you want this offense to operate?
Ugh.
Because I know what everyone's thinking, and well, you're going to say exactly what everyone's thinking. So please tell me what you want to do against Detroit if you're the Eagles offense, and then we'll go from there.
Balanced offense.
Oh, what the fuck does
balanced
that
offense
mean?
It means a 60, like a 65-35 pass to run ratio, which is totally normal in the NFL. That is exactly what they should do. You're playing a Detroit team that cannot defend the run. They've gotten no better at it unless Rodrigo, get it? Rodrigo, because he was Rodriguez. Unless he is this magical run stopper week one against one of the greatest offensive lines I've ever seen in my life. Unless he's that kind of guy, which he will not be, then they're going to be able to run this ball consistently. And, like, I was wrong the other day about Trey Sermon. He's on the 53, so he's going to play. Like, I would figure you're going to see it, like, he's going to get a lot of snaps, I think, in this game. Gainwell, Scott, Sanders, like, all those guys have opportunity to do it. The whole offense is new. You're playing a shit team. It is a weakness of theirs. You've proven it. There's no reason, when this was the game that rallied them last year and saved the season and maybe Sirianni's job, who knows. There's no reason to get away from that and just immediately come out of the gates firing the ball like crazy. Just keep it simple. Do what let you win before.
Has everyone seen tape of Jalen Hurts last year?
Yeah.
Do you think that the Lions are going to stand there and be run on from the first quarter, second quarter, and the Eagles are just going to go, yeah, we're just going to do that anyway? After all offseason, we are complaining about one football game against Tampa Bay and the Buccaneers defense. And what did they do, Vince Quinn?
They put 11 guys in the box. It felt like 10 in the box.
So what the fuck do you think the Lions are going to do? They're going to put 11 in the box. They're going to go, all right, tough guy. All right, muscle man. All right, you got A.J. Brown? I'll respect A.J. Brown, but we're putting 8 or 9 in the box. Go. I don't care if he's, you know, we'll double cover A.J. You can go with Devontae. But I'm going to get you before you can throw the ball because I know you're going to run out of that pocket. That's exactly what it – like, everyone in the league thinks that. You think that. Taylor thinks that. They're going to come out 4 wide, 5 wide, and say, fuck you, stop us. They're going to put so much of this on the air. And the one thing that I noticed from last year, do you know this entire, like, all the off-season training camp reports of, like, A.J. Brown – telling Jalen Hurts to do 2 things. Overthrow me. Give me the ball. Give me the 50-50 ball. And how many 50-50 balls have they been throwing in practice? Just by beat reporters' eyes. Who cares if they completed them or not? Tons, right? Maybe I'm wrong. 215-509-5833. Double check me on that. But the very first offensive series that the Eagles have – third and five. Jalen Hurts is rolling out, almost fucking gets sacked for a safety. Throws a beautiful ball, jump ball, perfect jump ball. Who does he throw that jump ball to?
Jalen Reagor.
And what does Jalen Reagor fucking do? Drop it, have no idea. And if you replace A.J. Brown with half of those jump balls, even from the Detroit game, a 44-6 game. Whoa! 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 They're going to come out throwing. And that's what you should do. This whole comfort thing of like, this is what we did, and this is what we want to hug, and it's a bunny rabbit. We're on the football. Like, if you signed A.J. Brown, have Devontae Smith, redid your entire offensive line, are sticking a carrot up my butt about how good Dallas Goedert is going to be, and you're going to run the football, the weakest fucking part of the offense, which you and everyone else has said, other than, like, the Miles Sanders stands that are going, it's going to work this time.
Yeah.
You know, like, throw the ball. You've got the three baddest motherfuckers, and they all – Jalen Hurts, Devontae Smith, and A.J. Brown. And if we were making a NFL blitz 3-on-3, that's exactly what the game would be. So throw it.
Great.
Go. Let's put the pedal to the metal, RPO to death, and throw, because they don't think Jalen can.
And I don't know if he can.
That's
so
exactly
I'm not
the way you got to do it.
If you do what works and then you figure it out, you make him prove it. He's got to prove
make
that he
him
can do
prove it.
Yes, what was my biggest worst case scenario for the season was that him and A.J. Brown don't connect, especially right away.
You better fucking find out
against
the
Detroit
Lions.
Well, you're going to take some throws, but I'm not basing the whole offense on that for the first week in a layup game. Yeah, take a couple of shots and experiment with some shit, but like, what is the main game plan? You're going to run the ball because it works with this team against that team. It's a good sound strategy. You've already proven it to the point of 44-6. Why walk away from that?
Because like, there's 17 games. This is not these first four. I even hate to say this. Don't matter. This is still the preseason.
Oh, no. No.
You got to figure out who you are.
No.
What happened last year? They choked back because they're like, oh, we can't win games, and we're embarrassed, and we're 2-5, and we got to go play the Lions. All right, run the football. Do not get off of this course. The wide receiving core went from dog shit to amazement. We've heard comparisons, the best duo in the NFL. Why did you trade for them? Why did you pay for these guys? Fuck! I'll be pissed. I don't care if they fucking win because I'm just taking a cue from Kelsey and Hurts. The noise is rat poison. Do your job and throw the football, Jalen.
What percentage do you possibly want? I said 60.
Not percentage.
I said 65-35 run-pass split.
You don't run the football consistently until you're up 21. Until then, keep throwing.
Well, then they're never gonna run. They're gonna keep throwing all day. Like to get up 21 points, we can't run the ball.
Send some runs here and
no,
there, but I'm just
I,
saying.
All
throw
the same,
the ball.
To that point, it's just I don't think that's the right way to play this, and I have no reason to believe that the passing offense is that good right out of the gate.
If you pinch my balls off and
yep,
this whole
come
off
over
season,
here, come over here. My hands are ready. I got big, dirty, unshowered hands, and I'm gonna squeeze your balls off.
If there's 40 on the ground, like 40 attempts or something like that, and it's not to close out a game in the end, gross.
If it's getting you 5 yards a clip, you do it. It's sound football if it works, and then you set up all the other things. It's using the run game, kicking their ass in it, using that to set up all the other stuff. It's play action.
Not
you can
gonna
get
work this year.
Why would it not work?
Because
this year?
They know what's coming. They know what's coming. What can you possibly throw at them differently in this running game that Stoutland hasn't thought of for 1,000 years? He is the run game coordinator.
Yes.
There is no other way to do the running game unless you want to do fancy-dancy trick play bullshit. That's it. Where can you find different in the running game?
You don't need different.
Yes, you do.
Why?
Because it's you. This team changed courses because it didn't have an identity. It was
yes.
the emergency cord. It's not a philosophy. We agreed on this for 6 months. This is not, they're not gearing up to be more of a running team.
No, I'm not telling them to be like a 50-50. I'm saying if the balance is there, I don't want them to think we can throw the ball more than most teams because we're so fucking good at it. They have not earned that, and I have no reason to encourage them to play that way.
Go get a dog, not a D-A-double-G dog, a puppy dog.
Nitus.
Look, if Jerry Rice Nitus is dog football. But if I'm going to get... I've got to see this thing build and grow the right way, and it hasn't done it yet, so I have no reason to trust them doing it. I don't trust Steichen calling pass plays yet. I have no reason to do that based on his track record. Like, there's so many things about this team that, a team could go 10 in the box like they did, but are the Eagles going to run two tight end sets the same way or three tight end sets that led to that? Probably not. Your field's going to be spaced out a little bit more. The offensive line is so damn good that it doesn't matter who's at running back anyway, whether it is Sanders, Gainwell, Scott, Trey Sermon, it doesn't matter. So I can look at that and go, in any situation, rain or shine, this coming Sunday, they can run the ball. They're going to get 5 yards a clip at minimum, and they're just going to grind Detroit down. All that other stuff is going to be open in the pass game, and you can fucking put the dagger right in their throat. But you don't have to go in going, we're going to pass to set up the run, because that's not who they are right now.
Hey, John.
Yeah.
Vince hates fun.
Yeah.
Part 7.
It's part 98.
Winning is fun. Winning is fun. And
winning's great.
Yes.
To be a legendary, outstanding, a Super Bowl contender, this whole, like, tiptoeing around what an actual football team in 2022 actually has to do to be successful after it just traded for one of the best wide receivers in the league and a guy that you think is an all-star Hall of Famer on the rise in Devontae Smith. And you want to, again, run the football with either Kenny Gainwell, who I love dearly, but is coming off of an odd camp of injuries and stuff. Miles Sanders fully healthy for a second until whatever. And then you're down to Trey Sermon and a bunch of other stuff. So, like, it's not that strong of a running game. Because of the running backs is what I'm saying.
But the line is that good that it doesn't matter. Like, it doesn't matter. And if A.J. Brown is this good, which he is, and Devontae Smith is this good, which he is, and Dallas Goedert is this good, which he is, then those guys are going to push everything back. You have to cover that. You have to be over the top. Like, and that's the thing. If they go down and they go, look, we can't stop this running game, and we've got to go put extra resources in it, that's when you just go, fuck you, and you throw it over the top, and that's John Barchard football. Like, those moments, I'm not saying don't throw the ball over 40 yards ever. I'm just saying that shouldn't be your primary game plan. Like, this isn't the greatest show on turf Rams
yet. I'm not asking for 20-yard bombs. I'm asking for RPO, back, throw. RPO left, back, throw. And that's where A.J. Brown is going to be or Dallas Goedert is going to be, and you just keep doing that. And when they get sick of that shit, then yeah, here you go, Miles. Here's a wide open lane where you can go dick around and play with for millions of yards before you turn around and miss the end zone again. Yeah, great. Fantastic. I can't wait for everyone, including you, to be so wrong about this, especially like the final like whistles as we're sitting there at Ford Field and it's 31-13 or whatever it is, and it was all mainly because of Jalen Hurts and A.J. Brown.
Look, I just got to tell you, I watched the game. I saw how they did it. I looked at this team. I look at the coaching staff. I look at the quarterback. My level of confidence in it right now, do I trust them to throw the ball 40, 45 times a game? Right now, I do not. I do not. I don't think it's a sound strategy. So until they show me that this can work with the second year in the system, second year with the coaching staff, new receivers, until they show me that that works, I don't trust it, and I'm going to work with what works, and I've seen it dominate this exact team, and I'm happy to see them do it again.
Well, Vince Quinn might not trust the passing offense quite yet. What he does trust is Vince over at Philly Sports Trips to make sure that we're going to be having a very good time at Ford Field. I've got one more note on Quez Watkins in the kicking game before we get out of here too, but I can't say enough about the partnership that started in May with Philly Sports Trips and is now like feels like it's going to blossom into eternity. Like, I feel like we're meeting a friend beyond a partner. It's just been awesome to kind of get all this stuff together. I can't believe we're going on the road and it's like here and we're settling in and it's like becoming a reality. for all of us. So, again, just having the greatest experiences, and we've only been to a few events, and we have never officially traveled with phillysportstrips.com, but we already know what's coming, man. I mean, the way that they are treating us is the way they're going to treat you. And if you go to phillysportstrips.com/bell, unfortunately, you can't come to Detroit with us. But if you're in Detroit, again, the tailgate tickets are there. We would love for you to hang out. It's going to be such a fun time. Everything is all-inclusive with everything that we do, including phillysportstrips.com. So that's why we love it. We don't have to worry about anything. The itinerary is planned and all that. So definitely do that. Our tailgate is starting, you know, freaking, what, 10 days from now? I can't do accounting at
yeah,
all.
Yeah, something 12? Like that.
But Monday night for the opener.
Monday night.
Those tickets are available right now. Head there, phillysportstrips.com/bell. If you can't make it to the one in Detroit, if you're not out there, it's going to be so much fun. So many other things and surprises that we can't wait to tell you. But more importantly, today, we hit it. 1,000 people are going to FedEx Field on September 25th. I can't believe it, man.
It's insane,
before
man.
Before the season started, which we didn't think was possible, we think we were going to need every last little hour up to the 25th to get 1,000. But, like, because of you, because of 4th and John, because of Hollis Thomas, because of Philly Sports Guy, because of all the support around this, including All About the Birds, our Discord, like, the Northeast gang that's in there, just so many different groups and people that are heading down here. It's going to be such a humongous, massive tailgate, and yet another reason just to go to phillysportstrips.com/bell, because you can still join us at the tailgate. Doesn't matter. We're going to fill it up and have a huge party. It's going to be like a damn carnival out there. So thank you, Vince, for an amazing offseason. Can't wait to get this started this year. Taylor, hit the lights. Jalen, I hope you enjoyed the offseason, because that's the last moment of comfort you're going to have. And if there was any comfort at all that went through your body or your mind, I want you to erase that right now and get right back to that awful discomfort that you feel the last time that somebody tried to take your job. Because that's happened to you a lot. And guess what? It wasn't any different this offseason either. When I saw the headlines of Russell Wilson, I thought it was going to happen. And I was preparing myself for it. I thought they were going to jump up and go take Malik Wilson. I thought there was no way that they were going to stick around with you. And you are here again, surviving yet again, just like you did at Alabama, just like you are continuing to do from Oklahoma to now, to surviving in a chaotic environment when you stepped in it when Carson Wentz was here and they thought you were just here to be a goddamn backup. And here you are, a year and a half later, with your best friends, with Devontae Smith and the best Hall of Famer of all time, Jalen. The time is right now. Jason Kelce is not here to fuck around and come around and wave his cap and say, thanks for being an Eagle. He wants to go win in a Super Bowl, just like 55 and just like 65 too. We're all agents of living in chaos and coming out and surviving in the end, which I know you're going to do too, goddammit. So pick up that ball and keep chucking it and don't fucking think about anything else, because we're going to the Super Bowl, goddammit, and you're going to take us there right now.